date for this much-anticipated middleweight encounter. The veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buff.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Paul Bejuclan. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, Paul Nickal.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, here we go, round one, and a lot of Bo Nickal's fights have been quick, so don't get up and grab anything from the refrigerator. This man is a submission machine. We have also seen his power on full display in the UFC. Three-time NCAA Division I national champion wrestler, and it's got to be hard for this guy, right? You get to the UFC, and it seems like the only thing that will be good enough at career's end is an undisputed UFC middleweight championship. Nothing easy about it. All right, so how about that? It did not take long for the wrestler to land a pretty significant strike. The uppercut gets through. Now, if you're on the other side of the BJJ fighter, perhaps this gives you a little pause trying to get this fight to the floor.
You know, wrestlers are known to have great hits. You can generate a lot of power when you throw the uppercut right, when you throw it from the hip, and he did exactly that.
Now inside the closed guard.
And he's gonna try to find ways to pass and move to a submission.
All right, side control now. A lot of top pressure being applied here. Nickal's back in side control here.
What he has to do here is just try to stay relaxed. Big explosive actions, panicky actions, are what gets you submitted a lot of times. That was a slick transition.
All right, half guard position here, DC. You have an extra hop in your step when you talk about fighters working out of this half guard.
Oh, man. I like half guard as a top fighter. I understand half guard as a bottom fighter. Don't want to be there. It's right. Very dangerous. But if you are there, you have to be winning the position of the underhook. It opens up so many opportunities for you to either escape or sweep.
Nickal's back in full mount. Nice positional control here. All right, so yet another ground and pound strike lands right there, DC.
He's getting very active now that he knows he can land these strikes.
When you get in a bad spot on the ground and you want to reverse it, that's what you need to do.
Masterclass in changing position. Unreal to see.
Oh, he postures up in a big head strike behind Nickal. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Pretty good work with the ground and pound here by Nickal.
Big ground and pound. He's in a dominant position. Look at him attacking the wrist.
Ooh, that Kimura looks tight. Oh, favoring position over submission.
Very smart decision. You never want to value the submission over keeping dominant position.
All right, so some high-level stuff there on the ground, but as they make their way back to the feet, a huge response from the crowd, no surprise.
I love all the grappling that was on display there, but fight fans want to see striking, and that's exactly what they're going to get as he finally makes his way back to his feet. I mean, this guy is really focused on
judo. Let's see if he can capitalize and lock up a sub.
You got to try to find whether or not you're going to land ground and pound here or if you're going to go to a submission.
Working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you got to be careful here.
There it is. Now he's going to mount. Yep, got to be very careful there.
Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground? Craig's going for the leg. Might be a submission opportunity here. Heel hook looks tight.
Oh, nice.
He's having his way with him here.
Getting him on here.
All right, So you gotta be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't wanna mess around for too long. Well, he's more than content to work off of his back, DC, where he has been a magician in his UFC career. All right, working on the ground here, his opponent's feet on the hips. Oh, that ghillie is tight. Oh, now he bails on the submission.
He needs to move. Yeah, he's got to move, John. He's got to shrimp and try to either get up or pull his opponent back into him so he doesn't have the posture to land that big damage. Down into his mount.
Well, he continues to manhandle him here on the ground. Round two is next.
All right, let's get this together now, man. Come on. I need you to wake up, and I need you to get out there. You're losing this fight, and I know you can beat him. Get out there, be aggressive. I want you to put him...
All right, so there's the end of the round. The storyline over those previous 5 minutes, volume takedowns, offensive wrestling.
Yeah, this is an exhausting type of fight, not only for the offensive fighter, but also for the opponent. Always being under attack, always being defensive, always reacting starts to really wear at your gas tank. It's interesting to see who is more fresh going into the next round.
All right, so perhaps a little frustration creeping in as our next round gets underway. Very close to submitting his opponent in the previous round, but was unable to do so.
Wasn't able to do it, but he was so, so very close. He's just trying to put himself back in that position, and maybe this time he gets the finish he wants so bad.
All right, so not exactly the approach we thought we would see out of this BJJ player. His ground game, you can argue, as good as anyone's in this division, yet he hasn't attempted a single takedown.
Has not even attempted a takedown. I would never have expected this, John. I don't understand what is going on in this fighter's head. He needs to get the fight to his wheelhouse, and that is on the ground in the grappling. I don't know, man. Pride is a weird thing, and it seems as though he's fighting with pride tonight.
Oh, side kick. Well done.
Oh, nice single, yes. He passes the half. Oh, right to the mount. Nice.
Nickal's right back to the full mount here. Making all these shots count. Up now.
And now the damage is about to start. Great shot from the top position. Yes, smart adjustment. Yep. Now he's going full mount.
Just over 3 minutes to go. All right, operating inside the closed guard now. All right, rubber guard for him now, DC. We haven't seen you lean on this in the octagon.
No, I can't get those legs up there. Come on, man, look at these tree trunks. They don't go up around nobody's shoulders. I like to keep my feet on the ground, and I like to grind. That's what I'm known for. But this guy has that dexterity. He has that ability to throw up the rubber guard, to be able to threaten from a position where his opponent was trying to find safety. There are many, many attacks here. Let's see which one he chooses to go after.
All right, side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks.
Nickal's right back to the full mount.
This is where he wants to be.
Just over 2 minutes to go.
Beautiful transition.
Bo Nickal, ground and pound from half guard now. Let's see if he can do some damage. All right, closed guard now. Nickal's back in half guard. He's very comfortable here.
Always offensive. Lands a shot from the bottom.
lands the ground and pound strike. Craig's in half guard now. Drops down inside the now closed guard of his opponent.
Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big ground and pound.
Might be a submission attempt here, champ.
I mean, you cannot sit in a full guard. When you sit in the full guard, you give these guys so many opportunities.
You need to work on standing yourself.
All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground.
In the half guard.
Well, we'll see who has the edge here as they get back to their feet after a pretty engaged battle there on the ground.
And both of these guys should feel pretty satisfied because they both had their moments and they both showed true skill on the ground.
Craig's eye starting to close up. Got to get that end swell on it between rounds if we get there.
He gets to the single collar tie. Look for him to drive and move it.
And an immediate transition to the judo throw right into side control.
He's in side control. He's got a ton of options.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here.
Big ground and pound.
10 minutes in the books.
All right, buddy. Sit back, relax, and breathe. Listen to me now. You're getting sloppy with those takedowns, okay? I don't want you just going blindly with a takedown.
All right, so there's the horn. That means it's the end of the round, and a lot of good offensive wrestling work from him over those previous 5 minutes.
I mean, great offensive wrestling. Every time he changed levels and got to his opponent's legs, he was able to secure the takedown. Let's see what type of fatigue his opponent will carry into the next round.
All right, so there's the horn. That means it's the end of the round, and get that man a singlet, man, right? Offensive wrestling on point tonight.
That was a tutorial. That was every single takedown you could secure in a fight. He did it all the right way. He's beating his opponent to the finish before he can try to sprawl and respond. He's a step behind. If he's going to stop these takedowns from the floor, he needs to react real quick.
Oh, there's the head kick. Looked like there might have been a window there. Instead, it is blocked by Nickal. All right, so now blood is a factor. You see that he has been opened up in that eye area.
Yeah, he's got hit in the eye, and now there's a cut. But it's nothing to worry about too much now. He's got to be very careful with it as we go forward.
Nickal's in half guard. Now drops inside that closed guard, DC.
Full guard. Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big ground and pound.
Nickal's back in half guard. Well, maybe ill-advised to be competing off your back, but he's landing. Excellent ground and pound there by Nickal.
This is a terrible position.
Well, the ground and pound has been on point tonight. Good work here by Nickal. All right, so good ground and pound by him here. Certainly staying busy, and not just busy, but effective.
You can just throw punches to keep the referee off you. This guy is throwing punches to be effective, to throw damaging strikes. He's doing a fantastic job.
Nickal's in half guard.
Nice pass.
Making all these shots count. Just over 3 minutes to go in our third and final round. All right, good movement by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement on the ground. You never know where he's going to be.
Oh, big shots from the top. All right, we'll see how he chooses to defend here. Oh, nice job to split his guard and get the ground strike home again.
He passes to half guard.
Nickal's back in full mat. Oh, getting leaky now. The hard ground and pound has opened up a cut. Continues to attack here. We'll see if he can set up the arm bar. Oh, that's tight.
It's starting to get really tight in there.
Oh, he's out of danger.
Great submission defense. He's able to take his arm out and stay safe. Now he's got a good body position. Yup. Nice defense.
Good work from the top here by Nickal. Man, another one lands. He's trying to pound his opponent's head through the canvas. Craig's in half guard. All right, we'll see if he can apply pressure inside his opponent's guard here, DC. Craig's back in full guard.
Changing the position.
Craig's got his hand looking for a guillotine choke.
Oh, that looks tight.
Oh, how good is that as he gets out?
That is great submission defense, keeping everything short and not allowing his opponent to get the submission victory.
All right, working inside the closed guard now.
Oh, he passes the half guard now. And he's not posturing to land punches, so look for a submission attempt. He's got to be careful here.
Oh, great reversal to top position by Craig.
You see him put himself into the half guard? Likes the control, yep.
All right, so we go down the stretch. He is clearly losing this fight. And at this point, you just abandon position and go for submission, yes?
Yeah, you got to just go. You got to start throwing things at the wall and hope something sticks.
Well, he is really starting to apply a lot of pressure here down the stretch. Not as much offense earlier in the fight. He is making up for lost time now.
Man, he has a great double leg. My goodness, he has a great double leg.
Man, look how flexible those legs are. He's got him in rubber guard. Craig's trying to get the triangle here. Let's see if he can close the show. Oh, compromising spot here. Triangle choke is locked in. Oh, he got out. Well, this is a tough fighter to buck off. Very good pressure and work here by Nickal. Oh, good ground and pound here. All right, so the fighters go the distance here tonight, but it went a whole lot better for one of them than the other. Talk us through the replays, champ.
Some decisions are different than others, and his striking really did separate him from the competition. He fought so well in the stand-up game that he should get a very easy decision.
All right, the official decision is in. It resides with the venerable Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. The judges score the contest
30-27, 9-28, 29-28.
Declared the winner by unanimous decision, Bonnet!
All right, well, nothing to argue about that performance. It does go to the scorecards, but an easy decision to render at that for my money. Just a dominant performance bell to bell for the wrestler here tonight.
He did a great job. I mean, he was out.